3 years. Apparently, I've been doing this for 3 years.
Why?
So yes, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. I have apparently been on YouTube for 3 fucking years. Well, this channel is now 3 years old as of about a week ago. I haven't actually stepped in front of the camera for nearly 2 weeks. I know I've put videos up in that time, but it's all stock footage. Stuff I had planned ahead to do because, well, I am currently working my ass off at my job. Because I'm trying to get a pay rise, so I'm doing extra hours. I've had fuck all time off. I've just done 8 days in a row, and I've got to do another 6 before I get a day off. And even then, it will be 1 day off, and I'll probably crash. So, fuck. The last anniversary for the channel, the 2-year anniversary, I did a video of Alex Kidd. It was a Let's Play where I determined to complete that game, because I had never completed it, and it was the first game ever played, so it was important for me to do that. You know, closure and shit. This year, I thought, it won't have something crammed along with it like that with the anniversary. I'll just talk about the channel, how it's done, where it started and all that. But I will do a little celebrationary Let's Play sort of thing. I'll tell you now, the Let's Play I want to do is Sonic the Hedgehog on Master System. It's going to be the next Let's Play you see. I've done that once before. It's a very old Let's Play, but I did that. It was one of my favourite Let's Plays I had done. And after a year of it being on the channel, someone left a comment saying, "Here, this video doesn't work. Something's wrong with it." I've gone, thanks, okay. I'll watch it and find out. I couldn't watch it, the fucking thing wouldn't work. But I knew that it worked beforehand because people were commenting on it saying random stuff. Antique Kraken, Zobster, loads of people had watched it, and like, if there was something wrong with it at the start, they would have said. I know they would have. Not to mention, I should have fucking noticed it. So this is like something that happened down the line. The video just went, I don't work anymore. Message YouTuber customer support thing, whatever it's called. And they said they'd look into it. Yeah, they looked into it, all right. They deleted it. They said, this happens to like 1 in a billion, apparently true, billion videos. Something goes wrong somewhere. Corrupt files get corrupt, and videos get cunted. And apparently you can do more damage to the system than just keep the video there. Because, I guess to find the cause of whatever's wrong in the video, you've got to cut it out. But if you can't find where it is, it's just easier to delete the video as a whole. So that's a real pisser for me, because that game, Sonic the Hedgehog and Master System, is also important to me. So that's what I'm going to do as the next Let's Play. Chill out and do that. Because I'm gutted that that Let's Play of all of them got taken down. It's a cunt. And lately I've been very, very stressed out, and whenever I get stressed out it shows on YouTube, no point lying about that. So when it gets to that point I stop doing videos that are requested and I just do something that I know I want to do, chill me out. And it's worked in the past. The main reason why I'm stressed out lately is because of work and all the shit I'm doing, but when you're stressed with one thing in your life, it affects everything else. So I'm super stressed and pissed off with YouTube when I don't really have a reason. It's all because of work. Everything that's going on in my working life has affected everything else. Family life, I'm being a snappy cunt to the family. I'm being a real dick. I know I am. I apologise soon after every fucking mistake I make. But, yeah. Life. Anyway, I thought we'd talk a bit of history about this channel. How it came to be. And, well, it all started very strangely. So I'll go back a bit further before the channel's birth to make sense. Obviously, YouTube is now my hobby, but I had a hobby before that. Making music. When I say music, you gotta do that. It's music, because it really wasn't. I did black metal. It was not your conventional black metal, because, alright, in case you're not into that style of music, let me put it this way. It's a very stupid scene. Very stupid music scene. One of the most typical examples of black metal is on a Dark Throne album called Transylvanian Hunger. I shan't bother you playing any of it because copyright and shit. But most black metal fans say, oh, you've got to do stuff exactly like that for it to be pure black metal. And I always thought, well, bollocks to being pure then. I want to do something a little weird. I like creepy music. Always have done. From horror films, horror games, as you may have noticed from some of them soundtrack videos I've done. So I thought my music that I make will be, how do I put it, weird and creepy shit. So mine was less your traditional black metal and more a industrial experimental type shit. I made 3 albums in that hobby. I think I'll play you a song now just so you... Well, not a full song. I'll play you a bit of one now so you can see what it's like. Be warned. It's very weird. It's meant to be weird. And the vocals, you're not meant to understand. Black metal is naturally a lo-fi style of music. It's not meant to be incredibly clear. It's just meant to be fucking evil. And I guess that's what attracted me to it. Anyway, here's one song.
I don't believe in hell.
But it believes in you, and it's out there right now.
The band itself was called Cold Crypt, and the reason I called it that was the only thing I cared about when starting the project was I wanted a band name that no one else had. And the name Cold Crypt, I just came up with it one day at work. I think I had some other band names, I've forgotten all of them now, but I looked all online on every metal website, metal archives and fucking everything. I couldn't find anyone called Cold Crypt, so naturally, I assumed there was no one. I was the first person to come up with this name for a band. So use that simply because no one else had. There was a logo as well, and the logo was made in Windows Paint. True story. I made that logo in Windows Paint. It's stupid. Black metal logos are usually really cool and strange and impossible to read in some cases. Like, the reason why I wanted to do black metal was I was inspired by a one-man project. And the band, the project was called Leviathan. In that logo there, it actually says Leviathan, but good luck finding all the fucking letters. That's why I got this tattoo here. Inspiration. While I don't make that music anymore, I still consider that an important part of my life, making that music. So, yeah, tattoo. I think my favorite album that I made was this one. It's the second album called Bearing the Light. CD isn't the same thing, basically. Oh, and you might be able to tell that this here is me wearing a style of makeup called corpse paint. It's quite an in thing in black metal, and still is, and it's one of the reasons why I got out of black metal. The more I made the music, the more I wanted to try and mix it up and make creepier shit. I was drifting more and more away from the standard style of music, and I had gotten to know a huge community of people, and everyone in it, or 90% of people in it, was so fucking toxic. I'm not saying the entire music industry on the whole is toxic, but I had been on a few labels, record labels, all little ones of course, no big names, fuck me no, but yeah, I got ripped off a lot, as well as on magazine things. I'd been in a couple of magazines and I got screwed, royally screwed. CD trades, everything like that, I kept getting ripped off. It was always something toxic. Whatever way you looked, there was something bullshit. And every other band that you tried, all right, look, let me put this. Nowadays with YouTube, If I get to know a YouTuber, we can collab back and forth, have a laugh, and we remain friends, and we chat gaming shit and stuff like that. It's great. But in the metal scene, you try and get on with a band, maybe you do a split album. How do I describe what split album is? It's where two bands throw together some songs and they come up with an album like this one. This is the only split album I ever did with a band called Smorg. They were some of the few people that are actually decent people. But every band, well, at least it felt like every band, Smorg not including that, but so many bands just wanted to make themselves bigger and use you to do that. I got used a lot, I got fucked around a lot. Everyone was a cunt in my eyes, and the whole corpse paint thing, well, it made you feel unique and even a little bit powerful in a strange way. Every fucker did it. Everyone wore corpse paint. They were all going on about their individuality as a musician or a band when they looked the fucking same as everyone else. I don't get it either. But at least with my music, I wanted it to sound different. It started off looking, appearance-wise, like nothing particularly special. Don't get me wrong, I'm still very happy with that artwork. The artwork I had on my third album, which you'll see here, that was much cooler, really. It was made by the same artist. He told me, well, no, he asked me what I'd want. I described it the best I could. I wanted it to be about the dead and the dying, general hatred of life, but no blood, no gore. I didn't want to, how do I get it? Tend to the masses on that one. I didn't want gore for the sake of gore. It's not meant to be a bloody style of music. It's meant to be a freaky one. So let's focus on the freaky. But after about 3 years of struggling through a hobby, I thought, why the fuck am I doing this? I know why I started. It was a great way to express myself because I'm a very negative person. I know I hide that quite well in some of my videos, but I am quite fucking negative. And making this music was a great source of, how do I put it? It was just a great way to push the negative emotion into something constructive. Because negativity is fucking hard to make something out of. How can you take something so horrible, like terrible feelings, depression, all that, and put it into something positive? It's fucking hard, but I managed to do it with that. Until it got near the end, when the third album was finished, I couldn't be fucked anymore. I was just sick of doing it. And I wanted to put the final nail in the coffin. I made an EP, just called Cold Crypt, with some basic songs, all ambient tracks. And it had my favourite metal-ish songs, because I did so much creepy stuff and ambient stuff. I didn't do solely metal. It wasn't like every song was just constant weird metal. It was like, no, bit of metal, maybe intro here, outro, weird shit, stuff like that. My favourite metal track is this one. In terms of ambient tracks, my favourite one was one called Passing Through Whispers, I believe. Passing Through the Whispers, it's been a long time, not even certain. And for that one, I don't know why, but I wanted to make a little video. So the first video I ever made wasn't a Sega Head one, it was that. But it was deliberately poor production because I wanted it to look old. old school video style, something Omen-like maybe. I don't know. But I knew what I wanted and I managed to make it. I thought it fit in with the music incredibly well. I'll show you a bit of that video now. Stuff. It got to a point where the ambient stuff was more enjoyable for me than the metal stuff. Although, in case I didn't say already, I'm not sure. I did all the instruments in Cold Crypt. I did the guitars, I did the drums, although for a lot of it I used a drum machine because I was never happy with anything I did drum-wise. Bass, there is some bass in some songs, but majority-wise, no, there ain't a lot, just because it didn't seem to sound right. Nothing to do with being able to play it or not, it was more a case of it doesn't fit. So I'd try it and I'd end up taking it out anyway, so it was a waste of time. But the vocals progressively got more, I don't know, demonic maybe? No. Banshee-ish, freaky-ish, ghostly-ish. Yeah, the freakier the vocals, the more proud I was of them. So, yeah, I guess I got what I wanted out of that. But it hit a point when I wanted to do nothing but ambient shit. And the annoying thing is a lot of black metal bands do that. They go from pure metal and then they do an album that's all ambient. And I thought if I do that, then I'm just doing the same as everyone else again. And I'm not achieving anything, nor will I feel like I'm achieving anything. So I decided, fuck it, Cold Crypt is dead. No more, I give up. And I didn't do anything really hobby-wise for 9 months to a year. And then I went round my friend Mike's house and my laptop was a little bit punched. I broke it. Went round there and he was going to help me take some stuff off of the hard drive, which still had a bit of life in it, and plop it in an external hard drive until I got a new laptop. He was trying YouTube at the time. He wanted to make his own channel and make a living off of it because he had been in a horrible car/motorbike accident and he was stuck at home for over a year. There was a point when the doctors thought they would have to amputate his leg. Luckily that didn't happen, but for a while it was very scary for him. And he was trying to be constructive by finding something he could do. And YouTube, of course, is a thing you can do when you're at home, piece of piss. So he was looking into that. I come round for laptop repair, and I said, how's your new thing going? Have you got it all sussed yet? He's gone, oh, I'm looking into the pricing of camera, better camera, editing software, all of this. This is Mike, he plans everything like a mile before trying anything, but that's his method, that's how he works. He said, how would you like to be in a Let's Play? Well, what the fuck's a Let's Play? Boom, all of a sudden my face is on his computer screen. Well, yeah, hang about, what's happening here? And I thought it was live stream, I thought maybe we were already being projected on the internet. I'm like, Mike, what the fuck am I doing? Hey, what the fuck? He said, don't worry, I'm going to click record in a minute and we'll play a game. What do you want to play? Anything. I can play anything. I'm gone. Alien Isolation came out a little while ago. I still haven't fucking played it. He's gone, brilliant. We'll play that. Gone, oh, okay. Gave me an Xbox controller. You cunt. You know I hate Xbox. Anyway, that was the first thing I ever did on YouTube. We'll put a link right here. sending you to that video if you want to watch it. I have nothing to do with the editing on that one or a goddamn thing. I'm merely in it. Unfortunately, Mike didn't pursue YouTube. He gave up in the end, which is a shame. I think he had the potential to go further. Yes, that video doesn't have fantastic editing, but so what? Everyone's first video is like that. You got to have experience in videoing and shit before you even try YouTube if you're not going to have a crappy first video. Just the way it goes. But Mike would phone me at work and stuff like that, and he would say, like, what to do for a YouTube name, because he wanted me to be in his YouTube channel for some fucking reason. And I gave him a bunch of names. He didn't like any of them until we hit one and we just stuck with it. Gomlet Gaming. And I just said, how about Gomlet Gaming? He gone, Gomlet? Why Gomlet? I said, Gomlet, Gaming Omelet. He gone, why Omelet? Why the fuck not? Well, like with Cold Crypt, it was a name that no one had ever thought up. At least no one that we could fucking find. Someone had something similar, but spelled Gom like bomb. But I think they were a lower unknown YouTube channel, like mine is now. So you didn't feel like you were ripping anyone off. The spelling was different anyway, so fuck it. But he had me back on a part two of Alien Isolation, a couple of videos where he was experimenting stuff for his editing and learning to edit, and those ones didn't go up. He did one on the new Gauntlet game. Yeah, there was various stuff like that, and he would always ask me for advice on how things should be or how I think they should be, and I always gave my honest opinion. And Mike being Mike, he never listened. Cunt. You know you never listened if you're watching this. And then it got to a point where one day I thought, you know what, I'm getting a little bit annoyed of constantly giving my opinion but never seeing that opinion come to any fruition. So rather than get annoyed at Mike, which isn't fair, it's not fair to get annoyed at him for not taking my advice on, he doesn't have to, I decided, fuck it, I'll make my own video. But I didn't know what I wanted to do. So I just did what I always do. I go to the car boot on the weekend. Back then, you found a lot more cool shit at the car boot. And I videoed it, and I made a funny-ass video. Well, at least I thought it was funny. It was just a one-gag sort of vid. It's very short. It's called Sega Hunt. And in that video was made in Windows Movie Maker, which is the biggest load of wank I've ever used. Fucking hell is shit. It took me so long to edit that video. Two reasons. One, Windows Movie Maker is bollocks. And two, I've never edited a video properly before. All I had done was that Passing Through Whispers video, which was very basic. And I can't remember what I made that in. What the fuck did I make that in? It's a good question. I don't know. Fuck it. Anyway, I made that video, showed it to a couple of people, Chicken being one of them, and he said, you should put it on YouTube. Going, oh what, on Gomlet Gaming, Mike's channel? He's going, no, bollocks, use your own. Yeah, okay, sure, why not? And then I'm back to that process of I got to think of a name that no one else has ever had. I came up with the name Sega Head pretty quick. And the only reason for that was I was listening to a song by Venom called Hammerhead. And I just imagined the intro, instead of being Hammerhead, I thought, wouldn't it be cool if it goes Sega Head? I thought, fuck it, that's stupid. I looked all online, there's no one called Sega Head. What? That's a pretty simple name. Someone must have had it. Well, no, I found a band that was around in 2001, I think, called Sega Head. They were around for about 5 minutes. They didn't make any of their own songs, I think. Might be wrong on that, but I think they didn't do anything. Yeah, they were around 5 minutes and then they quit. Or changed the name and did something entirely new. So, there you go. I had my own name for the channel. I started pissing around with logos and stuff. I just wanted to fuck around with the vids. That's why the first one was dumb. The second one was, like Mike, experimenting with editing. That's that Sega Yoga one. It was good fun, just to piss around. And then later on, when a few people at work had seen my videos, they laughed at the stupidity in it all. I said, what are you gonna do next? And I said, I've recently got this new software called Wondershare Filmora. I still use it to this day, in case you're interested. And I had discovered the ability to do split screen. While I discovered the split screen ability on the software, I was using it wrong. I did a crappy job. But I enjoyed making that video. That was Hillbilly vs. Poshnob. The lighting is bollocks. The camera picture quality is bollocks. The split screen is bollocks. Yet it's still quite funny. And that really was the first little reviewy vid. And I thought, I want to do something like Angry Video Game Nerd / Pat the NES Punk. So not entirely angry. I want to focus on games I love. I want to do something like that. But to make it simple for myself, I thought, there's more things you can say about a game you hate rather than a game you love. So I thought, for the first one, fuck it, I'll just do a game I know I hate. Virtual Fighter 2 on Mega Drive is a game that baffles the fuck out of me. It shouldn't exist. It's shit. It shouldn't even be alive-ish, whatever. I don't know why it exists. Saturn version. Game famous for being 3D. I know, we'll make a 2D version. You fucking stupid, you're sacked. So that seemed like a good first thing to focus on. The funny thing is, now that I look back at that Virtual Fighter video, oh god, there's so many things wrong with it. The cropping is bollocks. The footage, camera quality is a bit better because I got some slightly better lighting, but that's still a bit bollocks. The video is very cringy for me to watch, but I can't deny there are some really redeeming things, like the Mortal Kombat joke at the end, I find to be very funny. Certain other bits that I won't go into, yeah. I was proud of the video, but not proud enough. When it was done, I thought, I like this new style of thing, but I want to do another one. I want to make the next one right. And Halloween's coming up, so I thought, fuck it. Horror games, gonna do Doom. But Doom had to be Sega, because that was the whole theme I was going for on the channel, so I got Doom on Sega Saturn. I had everything planned to cover Doom. Played it for 5 minutes, thought this game is terrible. It's fucking bollocks. But it's not like something I can go into great detail and make a whole video of why it's bollocks. No, it's just shit. So I knew I had to change tactic, so I went and covered Alien games. But I thought there's still a bit of a joke worth with this Doom, so I made the Doom joke, which was the first highly edited, many footage camera-y bullshit joke I did. I was very proud of that. That Aliens game one, well, it's got a lot of certain things in the script that I wish I had done different. The jokes are still fairly good. I'm still happy with that video. But thing is, it had gotten to a point after the Aliens one where I realised I just kept wanting to improve on it. And it kept going like that. I kept making more videos, trying to improve each time. I didn't always succeed. I'm not pig-headed. I will not say, oh, I'm better than ever. No, I'm just different. But there's one thing I miss about the early days of them videos. And it was that I wanted to focus around this thing. Sega Master System, more specifically the Sega Master System 2, but it doesn't really matter. As a collector, I collect many different types of games, but this is the only console I want to collect everything for, because it's possible. In total, I think there's only 315, give or take a couple, 315 games for the system in the world. That's it. That's a fucking small library. Obviously, some of them games are stupid rare and stupidly expensive. Maybe one day, but the goal is still really interesting and fun to play these random ass games. I have a great history with this console, which I've covered in the My Life in Gaming Part 1, if you're interested, it's there in case you haven't seen it. I want the channel to go back to Master System more. I want it to not completely lean that way. For example, the next Sega Head episode that I'm doing is a much more modern game, and it's going to be a short video, but a very jokey one. Then after that, I'm going to do shmups again, because I was very happy with the Sega Head shmups video, and I left it open for a part 2, so I'm going to do a part 2, especially because I've got so many shmup games. Shoot-em-ups. Why do I say shmup? I hate the fucking word. But yeah, I want to do a part 2 to that, because I've got so many games for Master System and Mega Drive. Saturn, virtually none. Dreamcast, virtually none. But I don't fucking care. I think Master System's the thing I want to cover, and Mega Drive is the thing that people just can't get enough of, in my opinion. That's how I think it is. Master System is probably the least talked about Sega system, whereas Mega Drive is the most. So I mix it up, you know. Also, I got a YouTuber Yeah, I'll just say YouTube. I won't go into more detail. Someone wants to do a collab with me in that Shmups video. Unfortunately, the Shmups one won't be done for a while, but yeah, there'll be a future collab, the first collab in a Sega Head episode. I've done a lot of collabs as of late. I did one with Do You Nerd, Button Bashers, Nerd Layer, and they've all made me realize one thing. Each one of them wanted me to do like a Sega Head episode, but it had to be fucking short, like 3 minutes long. I thought, how can I fit game review, a detailed opinion, and plenty of comedy in 3 fucking minutes? And somehow I'm proud of each one of them videos. It done tremendous. The Do You Nerd one was about the YouTuber of the Month thing. That was really just comedy, not really a review, but I put my all into it and I'm very happy with that. The Button Bashers one, I got to do more reviewing, so I went ape into that. I was in charge of my side of editing, but Button Bashers did the cutting at the end. So when it went from me to them, they were in charge of that. That was the editing they did. I'm very happy with that video as well. And the latest one, the Nerd Layer one, I got the cover Bug. The game Bug is one of the ones from my childhood, so it meant a lot to me to do it right. And that was the difficult part, because again, 3 fucking minutes. It's got to be a short video. I want to do this game justice. Somehow I managed to cram all of my thoughts and the jokes and all of that shit into the 3 minutes. I'm very happy with that video. And it made me realize something. The last Sega Head, proper Sega Head episode that I did was on Soul Reaver. My all-time favorite game. Tattoos from Soul Reaver, in case you don't realize. I wanted that to be covered properly. I wanted to do the fucking Soul Reaver video forever. But when I had finally done it and voiced everything I wanted to do and made sure it wasn't too comedy based, because I didn't want to just rip on the game for the sake of, oh, I have to be comical. It's like, no, just do what I want to do, you know. When I finally finished the video, looked at the timer, 45 fucking minutes. Like, oh my God. That's far too long. No one will ever watch a 45-minute video. Unless maybe it's a full playthrough of a game, let's play. That, yes. Sega Head episode, no. I thought, what am I going to do? Then I had an idea. And it was all thanks to the Angry Video Game Nerd. I noticed he did Terminator Part 1 and Terminator Part 2. And he had done Part 1s and Part 2s with various other things. I thought, that would probably be a much better idea as long as Part 1 and Part 2 are brought out near enough at the same time. So, Part 1... on one weekend, next weekend, Part 2. So I did that. So my last Sega Head episode is a fucking long one. Next one, I'm going to do much, much shorter, because I've learned from the collabs I've done that I can make a short video be funny enough and interesting enough. In my opinion, I think I can do it. So that's what the next one's going to be. Especially because all Sega Head episodes, I've got one fucking rule with them. Stuck by it all the way. Each video has to be incredibly different from the last one. Obviously with Soul Reaver Part 1 and Part 2, doesn't count, they're the same video really, they're a whole. So, different from the one before. The one before Soul Reaver was of course the Mortal Kombat one. That fucking video was weird. Long, weird, covered many games, then to a detailed, interesting sort of one, all on one game. And this next one game again, but it's gonna be all comedy based. The seriousness is going to be low. Throughout doing this on YouTube, there's been a few times when I want to quit. The first year was shit. I had been on YouTube for, well, let's see, to be honest, a year and a half. I was on YouTube for a year and a half, and I thought, I've got 63 subscribers. That's pathetic. And it got to a point where I really cared about the numbers, and I thought, this is stressing me out and it's going a cold crypt way. I should quit. But unlike cold crypt, I had people that were paying attention. People were watching my stuff. Whereas when I was making music, I didn't think anyone fucking listened to it. But I told everyone via the videos, I'm thinking of quitting. I'm thinking of throwing in the towel. And I told everyone months in advance, I said, you know what, I'm going to be fair. Because I can't decide fully, if I haven't decided to stay by Christmas, fuck it, I'm off. Bye bye. And that's exactly what I was going to do. I was going to quit. And then someone called Maz Gaming discovered me through someone called Insert Coin. Insert Coin make t-shirts and various other clothing. They do a really cool PlayStation jacket that my wife wants. Can't afford it, but it's still really cool. And Maz did a thing on Twitter. And then one day my subscriber count is booming. By Christmas, I had 103 subscribers. So I'd worked for a year and a half and got 63 on my own. And then he just says, hey, look at that guy. Boom. All them subscribers came flying my way. I'm like, fucking hell, is that all it took? That is my biggest failing as a YouTuber. I am shit at social media. The past few days, I have been on Twitter like, I don't know. In the past week, I think I've been on there twice, that's it. I don't do social media, I'm not very fucking good at it. Recently I thought about throwing in the towel again, but it's because of the stress of work. It's hitting me hard, man, very hard. And it's hard to enjoy anything, so I'm thinking, oh, I'm not enjoying YouTube anymore, maybe I should quit. No, I'm not enjoying anything at the moment because work's running me down. I'm so fucking tired. I'm so tired, fuck. But don't worry, I am going to carry on with YouTube. I still stupidly care about the numbers. I've recently lost a few subscribers. I know why I've lost these subscribers though. Other channels have come along and subbed to me. And every time a channel subs to me, I will check it out and see if I like it. And if I do, I subscribe. If I don't like it, then I don't subscribe. I think that's fair. But then those people get pissy and they realize I haven't subscribed and they go, oh, well, fuck you. And they unsubscribe from me. So recently I've lost a few subscribers, and while I can't prove it, I bet bottom dollar that it's because of that. Because people subscribed, I didn't sub back. It's like, if you want a sub for a sub, fine. Just tell me, don't do this poxy bullshit, you know. If you want me to check out your channel, ask, and I will. You don't even have to sub to me. I mean, it'd be great if you do, obviously. But if you don't want to, fine. If you just want me to check out your channel, just ask me to and I will. I hate all this bullshit back and forth crap. But that is basically it. 3 fucking years. Mad to think of it like that. I don't know what else to say about it. I'm very worn down, as I've already said, because of work. I'm going to have a fuckload of coffee in a minute and get ready for that Sonic the Hedgehog Let's Play. Which I'm going to get every Chaos Emerald and I'm going to fucking complete it, I tell you that. Now I'm doing it, it's happening. But to all you people out there who've watched my videos, or even just one, I just want to say thank you. Really, I've made this worth doing. As I've proven, really, I was going to quit because no one liked my shit. Or at least it felt like no one liked it, no one even knew about it. Now more people like it, know about it, and it feels worth doing. It really does. And that's all thanks to you. Thank you very much for watching this 3-year anniversary. Hopefully it'll make it all the way to a 4th year. Who knows? I'll try to keep the ball rolling, so to speak. I never know what I'm really going to do. I'm always planning the next few videos and then I'm brain dead. People seem to like the My Life in Gaming series, so that will end at some point. It's not just going to keep going. It will hit a wall and then that's it. Finale. That'll be it. Let's Plays. I still try to fill out the requests, do the things that people request, and I've done a pretty good job of that, I think. I'm happy with the way that's going. Sega Head episodes are still my number one thing to do, but they're very difficult in editing. They take a long time to do, so that's why there's not so many. In fact, I think I've only just hit 20 in them 3 years. The search for Sega episodes, unfortunately, they're dying, but that's because the car boot's dying. I don't find fuck all in the car boots anymore. It's not a thing. So that's the way that is. As for everything else, just keep on going with it, I guess. Game Poke's fun because I get to talk loads of random shit about random shit. So that's all fun too. All in all, I think the channel's done pretty good. 3 years with just over 500 subscribers is crap numerically, but fuck it, it doesn't really matter. That's the hardest thing you have to try and remember as a YouTuber. That's my big advice to anyone who wants to go for it. One, fucking do it. It is worth doing. It's worth trying, at least. Just fucking try it. But the hard part, the really hard part, is you've got to not focus on the numbers. And I admit, I suck at that a lot. I wish I had more than 500 subs. It's taken me a damn long time to get that far. That's the thing, if I ever decide to quit, which one day I will, all of them subs will disappear, but of course it'll mean nothing at that point. So if you have a go at YouTube, don't worry about the subscriber count. And if you want me to check out your channel, let me know. Leave a comment here or find me on Twitter. I will get back on Twitter. Yeah, just let me know, I'll check it out. Again, thank you very much for watching this. I hope you've enjoyed this little history lesson of the history of the lesson. I don't know what I'm talking about anymore, and that's normally when I end a video because I'm rambling like a prick. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.